Everyone, it's Ezra May, and today I'm reviewing Horrible Bosses because Horrible Bosses 2 is currently out in theatres in Australia anyway, so please check it out if you haven't already before it leaves the cinemas. It is so funny. I never watched this one before. This was in 2011, and for some reason I never watched it. So I watched it before I went to see the second one, and it is so funny. I love both. I think I love the second one just a little bit more. I don't know why, maybe because now I'm really invested in the characters. It's about these three guys who are being treated like crap at their respective jobs by their bosses, and they want a way to get revenge without actually killing them, because the thing is, these guys are just sort of your average guy. They're like the guy next door. They're not macho, they're not super nerdy, they're just kind of the guy trying to make a living. They try to hire a hitman first of all, and they get Jamie Foxx, who is a hilarious cameo. Well, not cameo, co-star. And he doesn't actually want to commit the murder, he just wants to give them advice. So the boys have to carry it out themselves, and of course they're freaking out and they get into a lot of situations. But overall, I'm talking about Horrible Bosses 1. That sounds so weird. The plan kind of works itself out at the end, but it's just really funny. The cast is Jason Bateman, Jason Sudeikis, and Charlie Day, and they have really great chemistry. They're best friends, and their bosses are Kevin Spacey, Jennifer Aniston, and Colin Farrell, which is just so funny. You have to see how they act. They are all completely in a different element. I've never seen Jennifer Aniston be this bad before, which is refreshing, but also, no, Rachel, what are you doing? Colin Farrell is basically a total weirdo with his comb over. You just have to watch to find out. It's kind of a guy's movie, but I really enjoyed it, and I don't normally enjoy this type of films, but I think it's because the three leads have this really funny dynamic and chemistry, and I really enjoyed it. So of course, when I went to see Horrible Bosses 2, I was so excited. I saw it with my friends, and there are three of us, so we could identify ourselves in each of the characters, and I'm basically the Jason Bateman character because he's always the straight guy telling them to, you know, not do things, or he's always over planning and overthinking things, and yep, that's basically me. I think Horrible Bosses 2 is so much better because, yes, you get some of the old characters back and there is a bit of a new storyline, but I just think it was, you know, it's been 3 years in the making, so it came out 2014, 3 years after this one. And you just remember how much you love the characters the first time round, and there are some really good one-liners in there, some really funny jokes. Jennifer Aniston is even worse, if you can imagine, but she's so great. I love her. Her body is okay. This is completely voyeuristic, but all the men look amazing in the second one. I don't know what it is, but they're all a little bit older, a little bit more, I don't know, sexier. The second movie has Chris Pine and Christoph Waltz, who are both geniuses, so it only got even better. I won't tell you what happens, it's just so suspenseful. I was on the edge of my seat thinking, are these guys good or bad? I'm really not sure. Check out Horrible Bosses if you haven't already. I give Horrible Bosses 9 out of 10, and I give Horrible Bosses 2 a 10 out of 10. That's probably just because I like watching their faces do stuff. But, you know, I mean, it's a good movie. It's just really funny, and everybody should watch it. Okay, that's all for this week. I'll see you in a fortnight, because now I'm doing Friday films every second week. Bye! If I had to pick a favourite scene, there's just too many. I think I like anything Charlie Day says, especially when his voice goes really high-pitched. In this one, there's a bit where they break into one of the boss's house and he's got a whole box of cocaine. Charlie Day sneezes and it just all blows up in the air, and then they try to vacuum it and empty it back into the box, but they didn't empty the vacuum, so there's all little bits of jewelry and stuff. So funny. Have to watch it.